It's taken the high ground in the milk price war. Now Woolworths is making the most of it. Coles isn't buying.
One thing I can't do as the CEO of Coles is disadvantage our customers at a time when clearly, you know, they're under household budget strain.
It's a retail tactic Coles and Aldi may regret.
Coles needs to put up or shut up. And I say to every Australian out there today is to turn your back on the big German and a Coles, to stick it up them and tell them to go and take a running jump and shop somewhere else.
An understandable sentiment until you learn that this minister has shares in Woolworths and Labor's making the most of it.
It's an extraordinary thing to do, and it's even more extraordinary if he stands to gain financially as a result of any boycott that might follow.
But Mr. Littleproud's office says he has just 25 Woolworths shares, along with other companies he regularly criticises. That aside, Labor argues any boycott would actually hurt farmers supplying Coles and Aldi. Those two supermarkets say industry-wide reform is a better solution. Coles says it is helping farming communities in its own way by accepting donations from customers and matching them dollar for dollar. Now, it promises to keep doing that, having already passed on some $16 million so far. The industry not impressed.
All products in all categories in retail move, at least with CPI, sometimes even more. Milk in this category has not moved for 8 years. This can't stay at a dollar forever. It's got to change, and it's got to change today.
The timing for Coles isn't ideal, today releasing its first half-year result since becoming a standalone company after demerging from Wesfarmers. The supermarket made $381 million for the 6 months to December, down 29% on the same period the year before. That was largely because of a $146 million hit caused by one-off restructuring costs. Coles customers also abandoned its service stations because of its higher petrol prices, perhaps a key reason for Coles being so sensitive about its milk-buying shoppers. Eddie Meyer, Nine News.